When it comes to testing the hardware of a computer and all of the different components that you have inside of a computer, there's usually specific software that you can use to test each one of these components, like the RAM, the hard drive or SSD, the graphics card, or any of the other components. And I've got dedicated videos on this channel showing you how you can test those components. But in this video, I want to show you an all-in-one tool that you can use to perform a system stability test and basically test individual components as well to determine if there might be any issues with it or just to check if your computer is running stable. Now, with that being said, the software that I'm referring to is called AIDA64. And if we have a look at the downloads page here, you can see that there are a lot of different versions that you can use. Now, in this video, I'm going to be using the AIDA64 Extreme Edition, and you can get it as an executable file, or you can just get it as a portable zip package. Now, as you can see here, this is only a trial version. The software isn't free, but you do get a trial period that you can use it to test your computer and just do a basic stability test on your machine. Now, before we do this, I just want to mention that you don't need to do a stability test on your computer. You can basically use this software to determine if you have any issues with your computer. So if you're already having issues with your computer, but you don't know exactly which component it is that's not functioning as it should, AIDA64 can help you in determining where the issue might be. Now, I'll also mention that this video isn't sponsored or anything. This is just the program that I've always been using to do a system stability test if a client reports some sort of issues on their computer and it's difficult to replicate or pinpoint exactly when the issues arise, then AIDA64 can help you in determining throughout the test where the issue might be. So I'm going to be using the portable version, and I'm just going to click on the download button here so I can go ahead and download that. Then I'll just use the first link here. If you do see any ads, just close those windows and it should start the download automatically. Once it's finished, you can just show it in your downloads folder. I'm just going to go ahead and extract it as well. And then once it's extracted, it's going to open the AIDA64 folder on your computer. Now, inside of this folder here, you're looking for the AIDA64 application. If you go ahead and double click on that, it's going to launch it. You might get some prompts. If you do, just click on yes or allow to all of them, and it's going to start launching AIDA on your computer. Now, once it's launched, you'll also see that the program isn't free. This is just an evaluation of the software, and you get 30 days to test it out. Now, if you only want to use it once to do a system stability test, that's perfectly fine, and that's what I'm going to be doing in this video. Now, AIDA has a lot of different features inside of it. I'm not going to be going through each one of them, but basically you can use it to get a whole bunch of information with regards to your computer and the components inside of it. You can see information about the motherboard, CPU, and a whole bunch of other stuff. But what we're going to be using it for is a system stability test, and you can access that by clicking on this icon here. If you click on that, it's going to open this new window here, and here you have the different components that you can choose from that you want to stress test. So here you can see you can stress test the CPU, the FPU, your cache, the system memory or RAM. You can also stress your local disks if you think there might be something wrong with it, or if you just want to test it. For this video, I'm going to select that. And then you can also stress your GPU. Now, I've made other videos on this channel showing you how you can test your RAM, your hard drive or SSD, and your graphics card. And I'll leave a link to that video playlist in the description of this video if you want to go ahead and check out those as well. And you can see when I just selected the GPU test here, I got this warning from AIDA, and it can fix this issue for me with regards to the driver timeout detection. And it also says that I do need to restart Windows after altering this value. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on yes. And you might need to restart your computer for that to take effect. But for the sake of this video, I'm going to leave all of these components selected. And then I'm going to click on start. And you can see it's now started the test. Immediately, the CPU usage shot up completely. It's using 100% of the CPU, and it's also stress testing the disk here. Now, you have some different tabs here. You can basically have a look at the cooling fans as well and see how they're performing, as well as the voltages. Then you can look at the CPU clock, and you have some info with regards to that as well. And then you can see some other stats here. Here I can see the temps for the NVMe, and this is a virtual machine that I'm doing this on, so it's not going to be completely accurate. I can also see the CPU clock and the CPU utilization. But what you can do now is you can basically click on the preferences tab down here. Then in the general tab, you can prevent the computer from going to sleep, so it can basically run this test as long as you want. But what I would do now is I would leave this test to run for a few hours or until I see it has some sort of issue. Because what this test is doing is it's basically using all of the components that you selected here under full load. And if you have some sort of issue with one of these components, the computer will either shut down or it's going to freeze and you can't use it anymore and you'll have to do a hard shutdown in that case. And if that happens, then you'll have to go and manually stress test each one of these components one by one until you can figure out what component's causing your system to fail or to freeze or to shut down, because that specific component is obviously not working properly then. So I'm obviously not going to test it for a few hours in this video. It's already tested for 3 minutes now, as you can see down here. But I would say that you want to test your computer for at least 1 hour if you do have some sort of issue with it, and you want to determine where the issue might be. So to stop the test, you can just click on the stop button here, and then it's going to stop the test. Then what you can do is you can click on save, and you can basically save this stability test result that you got. And I'm just going to save it on the desktop as a PNG file. And if we go ahead and open that, you can see we basically have log or proof of the test that we ran and for how long it was run. And we can also see from these graphs here how much CPU was used, if it was actually used under full load, and that type of thing. But this is a trial version, as you can see. I've mentioned that before as well. So if you're someone who works in IT, you need to stress test a lot of different computers, then you'll obviously have to buy the software. But if you're just a home user and you want to try and determine if your computer is running stable, then you can go ahead and download this app. You can do a system stability test for about an hour or whatever, and then determine if there is any issues with your computer. But if your computer is running fine, you don't need to do this. This is basically another method that you can use to troubleshoot any hardware issues you might be having. So you can use the system stability test and select individual components here to try and stress test them individually to try and determine where your issue might be. It's basically just another app that can help you with the process of elimination to determine which components might not be that stable. Now, like I mentioned earlier in this video as well, I do have dedicated videos on this channel that go a little bit more in depth on testing different components in your computer. For example, testing your hard drive or SSD, the RAM or memory, and even your graphics card. And the methods I show in those videos are different than what AIDA does, because those videos will show you how to do diagnostic tests on those components, and it actually tests the components for errors, whereas AIDA basically just does a stress test on those components, but it doesn't really do diagnostic tests to test the components for errors. So if you haven't seen those videos yet, or you don't know how to test those components, I highly recommend that you check out the playlist in this video's description. But I really hope you found some sort of value in this video. If you did, please give the video a like. And if you want to support this channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.